Morning, dear student. So we were discussing the Afripan poetries, and in which we have discussed the language barrier and the background of the African poets. And today we are to discuss the African poetry's first generation. The first generation of African poets relied heavily on the European literary tradition. Their poetry is seen as being imitative, drawing on the paradigm means model, the principles of composition in European literary tradition. Yeats, Eliot, Hopkins and Ezra Pound serve as a model for African poets of the first generation. That the poet should be gadfly. Gadfly means who annoy people, persuading and reproaching society in the Socrates tradition was notion widespread among the early African poets. The Denis Osdebe, Nigeria, H.I.E. Lomo, South Africa, Wam Dankwa, Ghana, are some of the pioneering poets who wrote in English. Osdebe's the poem were published in the West African Pilot. His collection is called Africa Sings and contains poems that are personal and political. H.I.E. Dolmo's patriotic and protest poem is called On Monroe Bridge, Johannesburg. The following excerpt gives an insight into his style. So, while discussing the first generation of the African poetry, as we have discussed the Indian English poet, in which we have seen how the first poets who writing in English, belonging to India but writing in English, just try to follow the tradition, just try to follow the style of European poets, because they were much more inspired than them, and just try to imitate them while expressing their thoughts with the help of their poetry. In the means that period is called imitative period, means they copy their style, they copy their matter, they copy, though matter was Indian, but they copy their styles and rhythm and all that. In the same way, in Africa also we come to know the same notions while writing in English. Though they belongs to Africa, but they try to write in English, but follow their tradition, their style of writing, just like Yeats, Eliot, Hopkins and Ezra Pound were their models. On the basis of their poems, they try to express themselves. And just like the poet should be gadfly. Gadfly means who annoys people, means with their writing, the poet should annoy the people, poet should so create some type of disturbance in the life of people. Such type of notions were at that time famous in Africa. In such atmosphere, we have the poet like Osdebe, H.I. Domo, and Kam Dankwa, Ghana. Such poems, poets were there to write in English. And there are some work, the famous at that time, Osdebe's. The poem were published in the West African Pilot. You should write it down. The poem were published in West African Pilot, and his collection is called the Africa Sings. Osdebe's collection of poetry is called Africa Sings and contains poems that are personal and political. Osdebe's poems are called the Africa Sings, and that collection of poems contains the poem on personal as well as political. Dolmo's patriotic means who loves his country, and protest poem is called the On Monroe Bridge, Johannesburg. This is poem by H.I. Dolmo's, and following excerpt give the insight into his style. Jerusalem can boast no better site, for here the world with a glorious scene is dight. O sweet miniature Edens of the north, O glorious homes, is gold but all your worth. This is the patriotic feeling we generally get from this particular stanza. how he loves his country and how beautifully he has described the Jerusalem. And we can see the love of his love towards his nation, and try to express it with the help of his poetry. Then Domo was passionate about his writing. He says, "My creative life is the greatest thing I can give to my people, to Africa. I am determined to die writing." And this is very passionate things about the writing we can generally find in Domo's, in the personality of Domo's. He says that my creative life is the greatest thing I can give to my people, to Africa, and I am determined to die writing. Until I get the last breath on this earth, we will try to write, for the people of Africa. This is the very determination we can see in the life of, in the personality of Lomo. Okay, then we have the major poet in that particular period, Roy Campbell. He was born in 1901 and was died in 1957. He was a prolific white South African poet, journalist and satirist. He was born in Durban, South Africa, and lived between England and South Africa. He was held in high among the poets, high standing among the poets of his generation, including T.S. Eliot, Dylan Thomas, but fell into disrepute on the account of his right-wing ideological leaning. The Flaming Terrapin, 1941, his first book, you should underline, this is the book by Roy Campbell, The Flaming Terrapin, which was published in 1924, his first book was well received. He published three poetry collections after that. His poems have been widely anthologized. They show an understanding of the great divide between the white colonizer and indigenous black population. South Africa became an apartheid state. Apartheid state means the black people generally living in South Africa without any rights or privileges. Africa became the apartheid state in 1948 with the disposition of the black people and their exclusion from the governance. And we know how they were conquered by the British, Portuguese and France, and after that they were dispossessed of their rights and of their governance, and that's why Africa became apartheid, the state of black people without right and privileges. So he just tried to expose their living, their oppression, their struggle to achieve their freedom and all that. How they were oppressed at the hand of British colonizer, white colonizer, and we know such type of feelings in his whole poems. The interesting thing about these early writers is that they were all highly educated in the British tradition and were statesmen and political leaders in their own countries. The early African poets were more concerned with the form rather than content, as is evident from their writing, and they just concentrate on their form, their style, not on the matter. But when we see the poem like Zulugal, written by Roy Campbell, in which we get the insight of that particular poet, how that Zulu tribe was conquered by the British colonizer, how they were disowned by British colonizer, and then they had to suffer a lot while working in their farm and all that. So with the just pathetic situation of the Zulu tribe, we can generally get from that the poem Zulu Girl. So such type of first phase we can see in the African poet writing in English. Then there are some nationalist poets. The nationalist poet like Agostino Neto, Denis Oswald, Leopold Seder Senger, and Antonio Jacinto gave voice to the African people and oppressed by the colonial subservience. Agostino Neto described the African colonial experience as leaning into shapeless dream, stumbling into servitude. And this type of feeling we generally are a condition of African people we can get in the writing of Agostino Neto. His poetry described the plight of Angolan people in the hand of Portuguese colonizer Bernan Daddy. The poet from the Ivory Coast celebrates the African folklore and tradition of his black identity in the poem "I Give You Thanks, My God." This is poem written by Bernan Daddy. You should also write it down. "I Give You Thanks, My God." This is poem Bernan Daddy, and he just described the African folklore, celebrate the African folklore and tradition. "I give you thanks, my God, for having created me black, for making of me the porter of sorrows, setting on my head the world." Very beautiful poem. This poem we generally have how he is consider himself very fortunate by being born as a black and leading the sorrows of all the black people. The Daddy's poem "Dry Your Tears, Africa," 1967. This is also most important poem you should write down. "Dry your tears, Africa, dwell on healing the wound of slavery, colonialism and neo-colonialism." The poets like Wole Soyinka, Christopher Okigbo of Nigeria and Kofi Annan Adenauer of Ghana oppose the nationalism and the romanticizing of pre-colonial Africa. They believe that this approach neglected the African tradition, all that. So dear student, for this particular video this is enough, and remaining portion we will discuss tomorrow. आपको अगर कोई दिक्कत आती है या कोई प्रॉब्लम आता है तो शुड लेट मी नो ऑन योर ग्रुप, सो आई मे बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड योर शॉर्ट कमिंग्स एंड ऑल द डिफिकल्टीज. ओके, लेट मी नो ऑन योर ग्रुप. थैंक यू.